Okay, so welcome to Venice. This match has already started, so we'll go straight in live in the studio. Myself, Eric McAlpine from the UK, Gianlazzaro and Bojo. Hi, guys.
Hello, Eric. Hello, everyone. Good to be back in the studio, and I really hope that today we are going to experience much better connection, being able to stay tuned.
Absolutely. So this is round three in the individual championship. Torsten looks from Germany versus Alain Babillon from France. First to 11 points, and this is the first game. Okay, 4-2.
And we already have an interesting kind of back game, as much as 4 or 5 points can be considered a back game, but it's massive with 7 checkers already.
It is indeed, and this looks like a double fives.
It is a double fives. He cannot move his checkers. They somehow have appeared on the 8 point.
That's right. Okay. Yeah, not much else. I think it's better than considering making the 1 point. Think his what do you think about his first idea, Bojo?
I think clearing the 8 is a good idea because he has to clear that point anyway, so why not taking a chance?
And you think the other way with the strip position, you might be more likely to leave some shots? Okay, he has gone this way.
He's gone this way. This is a 4 and 2.
Yeah, makes the 3. Yeah. Okay, he's moved that pretty quick. So we know that's a double threes. Clears the contact. Now he has the contact with the 6 point. From his 11 point, he's having a good think, but is that better than 2 there and then unstacking the 6? I think is maybe a little bit worse. Might be tough to get
home. I don't think unstacking the 6 is an option. It's either going to 11 or bringing the two in from the 9 point.
I agree. I would just go here. Now you've got 2s, 3s, 4s, and 5s to try to clear that 11 point. So this is my preferred move. Okay.
2-1.
Yeah. I think that's
again, he can consider clearing the 9.
Yeah, I like this a lot because it gives a lot more future play.
There is better timing, definitely.
Oh, no doubt about that. Yeah, and just ace, simples.
So yeah. Torsten looking for a 3-4-5 combination.
Yeah, doesn't quite get it.
Ace point now.
Yeah, keeping all those checkers activated. Okay, 42.
24, slotting the 4 point, maybe.
Yeah. Reasonable. Oh, keeping in contact. Trying to make it awkward
three
as possible.
Three times in a row. 3 times in a row, 1, 2.
Yeah, I think.
Oh, that's not nice. Yeah, there has to strip his 7 and 8 points, or he has to take a lot of risk and leaving a shot on his 11 points. So
yeah, I'm not sure about this. Yeah, I'm not sure because it may deteriorate if he gets a few more awkward rolls. That might have been the time to take the small risk and hit and carry on.
Okay, after 3 times 2-1, now 3-1, much easier, can jump.
Absolutely, absolutely. And Alan's got great timing here and just maximizing his checkers and the position to try and winkle out a shot here. Oh, very, very, very nice. Nice bit of French flair. Okay. All right.
I have a short freeze. I don't know how it's at your side.
Yes, I have a short freeze as well.
Okay, there it is. Double sixes.
Yes. Okay. One. Two. Three. Ah, okay, he's played them all. We missed the sequence before the others. Okay, 53.
That's a 5.
Yes. Yeah. I wonder what he's going to do here. Maybe make the point and slot.
He can make the deuce and slot the 3, or he can just pay now.
Yes.
Okay, we are experienced a small technical issue.
Yeah. Okay.
Waiting for the share screen to come back.
Yes. Apologies.
So, Eric, how did you like the final yesterday? Against Japan.
Oh, wow. I thought fabulous for the hosts of this event and for Team Italia to be the champions, World Team Champions 2022. I think it's a special moment for Team Italia because I do believe as well that they, was it last year or the year before, Boja, they were online world champions as well.
They are online champions this year, and then they're life champions this year, so they hold now both crowns.
Wow. Incredible achievement and thoroughly deserved. They do have a lot of community in Italian backgammon, lots of communication and good feeling. So being rewarded with magnificence in online and live world champions, team champions, I think a great effort, and this will spur them on to even more, I feel. Yeah.
Okay. We are now back to the game. Torsten has won game number one.
He has indeed. 1-0.
Double sixes.
Yes. Very reasonable. Okay. Yeah. I think that's right. Makes us 5, gets ready for action. Okay. Yeah. Six, two. Yeah. Okay, jumps out. Jumps out to 15. 5-2. Yeah, clears the mid. Nice configuration. Standard, absolutely. And nice configuration. Hoping to roll something decent next. Aha, 31. Yeah, unstacks. Very wise.
That's
from Alain.
That would be my play.
My play as well. Oh, very nice. Makes the 5. He's in business.
Okay, does he run from 24 or does he play to the midpoint and one in?
Good question.
Or one down and making the 3-point. That's another option.
Yeah.
Oasis of deuces, 5-3, 6-3, double fours.
Yeah.
4-5. Oh, that looks like a big double.
It does look like a big double. But I like Alain's play. I think if he gets out of this, he's in a much better position than hanging back. But yeah, I agree with Bojo here. I think he has a lot of hits. Okay, he decides to give it a shake.
That is the 5-4.
Yeah, and let's see what happens next. And 2-1. Okay.
2-1. This is getting gammonish already.
Yeah, I think this is okay. He doesn't even consider here. I'd have had to have a little look at that. So many activated numbers from the bar. I've had a little bit more of a look, I feel. Okay. 54. Yeah, 5 hits and covers. Very nice. Okay. It's 2 and something. Can't quite see the other die, but okay, picks it up. Aha, Alain likes it. Yeah, okay, double and take. Double ace. Aha, a few things here. I think making the bar might be... okay, he's going to continue to blitz. So 1-2. I think he's got to push at least one. 23-22. If he's going this way, and then think about... the final one. Two more to play. Okay, if he's doing this, then I think he's got to push the one on the other side. So he's peering out with the 6 into the distance. Okay, he decides to get more wood, bring more wood. Okay, 35.
I guess one in.
Yeah, looks best. Keep all the checkers in front. Can't be hit from the 11 point. So, absolutely.
And leaving no blots for the eventual hitting exchange later.
Absolutely.
5-6. No blots here as well. Good counterplay.
Very good indeed. And, lovely spinner.
4-2.
Yeah.
Maybe going to the 9.
Yeah, I think so.
Make the super stack even bigger.
That's right. Very difficult to win the game from there if you stack up too much. Yeah.
Clear hit the 4-point.
And fan.
And advance.
Okay, he's made it. Yeah. And then he can step up.
Oh,
so.
Nice turnaround.
Huge. Look at this. Looking very good here. If you can roll a 5. Didn't quite get there. So, okay. Looks like that checker may be coming in. From the 8-point. Yeah. Okay. He's thinking of something else.
It's between this and slotting the bar.
Yeah, I think with shooting at the other guy, there's okay, there's this as well.
I like this.
It's very nice indeed. Yeah. I think with shooting at the second block, there's no need to take the additional risk of slotting the bar.
Not really.
Yeah. Okay, Alain looking very good here for potential gammon. Yeah.
Okay.
Five outside.
Distribution.
Yes, very important. Try and get the close out.
Playing to the 7 point is clear. The question is 3 point or...
Yeah. I think seven's the
play. I like his first play.
I do as well. Yeah. I like his first play as well. Okay. Let's see which way he prefers. It's going through his thoughts here. May pick it up. Yeah. Okay, so apologies to the viewing audience. We're trying to do the best we can under these testing circumstances. Can only apologize for the break in transmission. Should be back with you very, very soon. Can be a little bit frustrating and a little bit annoying, but we're doing the best we can to broadcast to the viewing public these championships. Okay. Reasonably decent freeze here. So, Bojo, what do you think about Italy beating Japan yesterday?
I think that Italy seemed to be the most balanced team at some point. They look to have strong players in all five positions for the final. And after having seen the last couple of rounds, I'm not surprised at all, because they did great. I mean. Okay, we are back.
Oh, excellent. We're back. So, okay.
Is it a gammon or not?
It is a gammon. Yes. That's the G for Alain. Okay.
4-1, Alain.
Yeah, very decent. Rewarded with a lovely gammon there. Yeah. I'm sure that will put a spring in his step. Always nice when you turn the cube, maximizing cube value by getting his gammon there. Very nice. Yep, so 4-1 up to 11 points. 7 away, 10 away.
We are having a short break, it seems. After the end of the game, I think Torsten went somewhere, but
let's see if it's official break or whether it's a comfort break.
Yeah, it seems that Alain is waiting there in the chair, so probably
comfort break.
A long one.
Yeah, maybe a quick comfort break, and then he'll be back. Yes, so back to Italy. Yes, you were saying about
They doubled the title, online champions and live champions. So obviously a team that deserves a lot of credit, a lot of respect for what they're doing. This is a good example of how the society in one country can improve the quality of everyone, including the best players. That's what is obviously happening in Italy the last few years. They have a lot of events, a lot of tournaments, a lot of rising the number of players playing, and Also, Gianlazzaro is helping with making all those videos with lessons, with live streams. So yeah, I'm really happy for my Italian friends that they achieved such high standards in backgammon, and they are obviously becoming one of the best teams in the world. As for Japan, they didn't lose any match before the final, and they jumped into it as favorites. But yeah, the differences are super small between the best teams, and it was totally unpredictable. And the equality in the Italian team, I think, finished the job, winning the title for them. So big congratulations, Azzurri.
Oh, no doubt about that. And I would imagine it was an even more special moment for Team Italia, winning on home soil as well. I would expect they would have had a few glasses of vino to bring in their success. Thoroughly deserved, of course. And I'm not surprised at all that they did so well. Still, for me, in the world of backgammon, I feel that the Italian CMB circuit is the best backgammon circuit in the world, in my opinion. They put on wonderful events in beautiful locations and have such fantastic attention to detail in terms of the ambience, the location, the standard of the hotel, and also that they play with such high standards of sportsmanship and fair play as well. So definitely ones to look out for if you're considering a tournament. CMB Circuit of Italy. Very, very good indeed. So check them out. I think you'll enjoy the experience for sure.
I fully agree with you, Eric. I was there for two of the tournaments, Rome Open and Venice Open. And I can say that both tournaments were organized in a really great fashion in amazing locations. And on the top of that, I was very lucky to win the Rome Open and to play doubles final at Venice Open. So I have an extra reason, personal reason, to like the Italian soil. But again, amazing tournaments and the very good ambience. Everybody's smiling, laughing all the time. There is no negative vibe, which definitely makes it very different from many other events. And I completely can join you on recommending everyone to try a tournament in Italy, because this is always a very special and nice experience.
Excellente. And I think it would be a good time as we're talking about Italy. Welcome, Gianlazzaro.
Hi, Eric. Hi, Borro. Hi, everyone.
Now, hello, Gianlazzaro.
I can sit and have a look at the match. For the moment, just trying to solve some problems. But let's enjoy this nice match.
Congratulations, Gianlazzaro, for your team winning the title, and not only your team, because you come from the same country, but also we know that you are part of the team. This is your first time missing, because taking care of all the live streams and the live coverage. So I know personally that this was a special moment for you as well.
Yes, and of course, when I am not in the team, the team won, of course, but... but apart from joking, this time there are all the best Italian players. So I don't think that even if I had not to do streaming, I would have been a part of the team. Italian players are there are a lot of players that are increasing their level. And so I'll have to work hard to to keep my place in the team. But
in the meantime, we have the double. Okay, sorry, Gianlazzaro. Please continue.
No. I say that I have to work hard, but I am ready too. So,
okay. Yeah, watch out, rest of the world. They're going to be practicing even harder to keep themselves ahead of the rest. So, win-win for Team Italia, for sure.
And I win the last game for Torsten Lux, who is now trailing 2-4. 9 away, 7 away.
Indeed. Okay. Yeah, makes the 5 point.
Both of them managed to make the golden point in the first row. The beginning.
I think he's going to be splitting here.
I agree with you. Splitting against 8 checkers with only spares on the 6 point is a good split.
Indeed.
Looks and like against a priming formation, because it is the red and white position is more priming than blitzing. So it is important to split as soon as possible.
I concur with Gianlazzaro's analysis.
How about the 5 and 4?
Yeah, it's a tricky one.
Blitzing play with 3 blots or a priming play with 1 blot? He went for the blitzing one.
Yeah. Oh, and it's been rewarded. Yeah. Fraction too early for the cube, as Alain has his 5 point made and his back checkers haven't moved as yet. Okay. 26.
That's one option, yeah.
I think it's the other one. I'd slightly prefer the other one for the connectivity. Yeah. Just for the connectivity. Slightly prefer the other way. Okay.
Probably hitting the ace is mandatory because to take away one of the opponent's dice, because otherwise he's very strong.
Tempo hit.
Yes. We like it a la tempo.
And this is the Tavo hit in return.
Yes, he's
wait
straight
to play
there.
Anything else?
Yeah.
And the cube is very near unless it's already too good.
Well, I think what's he got? He's got 4s, 6s, 7s, and 11s to cover. Yeah, he does feel it's too good.
Decision.
One.
Two down, hit on the ace.
Yeah, looks good to me. I like your play, Bojo. That's right. He wants the undoubled gammon. So he goes all in. Okay. Yeah, makes it pure.
I'm not sure about this.
I'm not sure as well, but he prefers the purity. Yeah. Okay, 45-2.
Okay, small chance.
Very small chance indeed. But he does have maybe a bit of time there to make
especially
his anchor.
After the dancing.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Hits again. Yeah. There we go again. And fan. There's the closeout. Okay. Getting in the groove here. Yeah. Okay.
I keep the checkers as much split as possible.
Double 3 is okay.
It is. Double 4 was the only one that was not really okay, but still with 3 on the bar, even breaking the 6 point is not the end of the world.
That's right.
Breaking 2 points is already really bad for Torsten, but there is no option for that anymore.
That's right, and this is just a case of putting your checkers in the right place, ready for the bear off, and avoiding those pesky high doubles that may open up and leave a single blot in your home board. Yeah, so he's all fine. Flowing here with his checkers. Yeah, he's in his groove. fan.
Okay, 3-4, not the best. Probably not. Probably taking a man off looks better.
I think so.
Because playing two checkers from the 5 point to the ace and deuce leaves so many living shot numbers after that that this should be avoided, I think. He went for this one.
There's a few combos here, aren't there, that leave shots. He may rue that decision. Let's have a look.
This he is does. One of them.
Here's the immediate shot. And will Alain take advantage? And yes, he does. Look at this. To see the difference here. Bojo's. Oh, okay. He had this a different looks like plan.
It looks like a cash.
It does look like a cash.
No, oh, it doesn't look like a cash. Wow.
He's confident. Okay. No, I can understand why. What's he got? 8, 10, 11, 12. He's only got 3 off, so understandable.
Another fan.
And he does have his 5 point. Okay, we have ourselves a game. Yeah, probably wasn't a cash.
Another fan.
Yeah. He only had 3 off and 6 and 5 open, and he had the 5 point.
Oh, if he keeps fanning like this, a dirty double is coming soon.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, there's the three.
As much as possible. Well done, Alain.
Yes, he's ready.
Yeah, he is in. Finally.
Yeah. Took a bit of time. There's the 6 blocker. Needs a decent 4x. Doesn't make it. Oh, he's exposed in his home board now as well.
Oh, this looks like slotting the bar because of the blot on the 21.
No doubt about that. And then you're threatening to make the 6 prime. If it doesn't roll 4, then I think you have a cube out. So I think it's mandatory for him to just slot his 7 point here. I think that's the best move in this position.
He's not in favor of slotting, obviously, but I'm not sure about.
Yeah, I'm not in favor of this. I think the move was definitely to slot the 7, because then if he doesn't roll 4, you can cube out. But now he's going to have more chances to wriggle out from here is Torsten, for sure. And more challenging for Alain to win this game, I feel. Yeah.
This 10 point was absolutely not necessary because he's having now the difficulty to make the bar point because only double threes is making it.
That's right. That's right. And may you give Torsten quite a few more rolls to try and get the hell out of dodge. A little bit of confusion about where the checkers are. Yeah, so we know that it's definitely there because he picked up the block from the 4 point. So we know it's not there.
It's not there for sure. That's the clear thing.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Can he get what he wants?
Yeah, needs a decent size 4x.
Another 8.
Yeah. Oh, that's a great shake. Double fives. 1, 2. Yep, stick him on the roof. Stick him on the roof. You don't want to give him the chance to escape.
No brainer.
Yeah. 1, 2. 1 into the 5. Maybe.
And 1 into the 12.
Yes.
For better coverage against 1-6-2-5-2-6.
I like your plan, Bojo.
And I like your plan with going 1 to the 8, to the 5.
Yeah, I think so. No, because this
is it.
Yeah, this is it for sure. Yeah. Okay, that's
and
a
there
fan.
Are the double fours in case he didn't hit on the 3 point.
Yeah.
It could have been game over now.
Yeah, we got there after a few rolls. He's now made that 7 point. Okay.
He's not redoubling, which is kind of strange because he lost already.
He has lost the market big time. Oh, would you like to take my cube? No, thank you.
Okay, he took a cube that was, to me personally, a drop. And then he missed a couple of times to redouble, but still 6-2 in Alain's favor.
Yes.
He managed to survive in a very difficult situation.
He did indeed. Yeah, and I'm sure he'll definitely be as pleased as Punch about that. Propels him into a much bigger lead. 6-2 could have been could have been behind himself, 6-4 with a gammon.
By the way, we did congratulate Gianlazzaro for his team winning the World Championships, but I have also to congratulate you for your team winning the bronze medal, which is still a great achievement.
Aha, yes. I'm glad you reminded me about that. Yes. Team UK winning the bronze. Yeah.
So the stream team is well presented.
Yeah, that's right. We're doing all right, aren't we? Yes. Yes. Yes, very happy about that. Yeah. Great effort by the boys. Okay, I think we've got a little bit of a freeze. Hopefully it should correct itself very, very soon. Yeah, in this third round matchup. Oh, yeah, here we go. Okay. Yeah, so hit and then a 5 to play, I believe. Yeah, stays out of danger. 5 and now the 3. Yeah, just has to button up. I think it's 3-2.
It is 3-2 indeed.
Yeah.
So he went for the blitz.
He did. He's come in this hitting.
This time Torsten managed to come in right away without fanning many times.
Yes, so in and out, hitting. Okay, 43.
In and down, hitting.
Yeah, hits with the 4.
Now, does he hit from 18 to 17 or not? I think better not.
I think you have 18, to keep.
18 is too important, yeah.
It is, I think, with the 3-point inner board of Alain, far too risky to get into a block hitting contest when you've got nothing on the other side and opponent has superior position. I think the 18's very important, as Bojo said.
I think this is the play, duplicating the deuces and both options for hitting is from strip points, bar point and mid point, so not really in a danger.
Okay, that's a pretty good roll. He's going to make the ace point, and I think he may have to do a slot here.
It's not there.
Nope. He's played a double for... Oh, illegal play.
He played 9 and 9 somehow.
He played a... No, he just had a combo. He had a double 5 and 4 combination.
Yes.
So, very, very effective. I haven't seen one of those played for a little while, but I really like the move. Yeah.
And the strange thing is that Alain didn't realize it.
No, that's right. That's right.
That's a legal play, gentlemen. It's a legal play. You cannot play like this.
Yeah. I mean, and it helped his position massively. He made a stronger point and didn't put himself out of position.
Because no Torsten played it in a sure way. It was quite...
Oh, yeah.
Confident.
Hesitate. Yes, it was confident. It was the boot. happens.
Oh, look at this now. Yeah, yeah. You'd have had a lot more problems the other way, for sure.
I think it is a take.
I think so as well. You still got quite a bit of work to do to even consider making the 5 point. And he's still got two checkers on 18 and one on 24. So, yes, I agree with Gianlazzaro here.
I am still amazed with the double fives. I cannot believe that two experienced players can miss this in such fashion, because this was not something with an unusual play, playing like four different numbers, but this was just the very standard two down and two in. So I'm still absolutely amazed how this happened.
Yeah, myself as well. Okay, there's the 5 point.
But I am sure that if Alain was playing against a weak player, he would have caught him immediately. But of course, he trusts Torsten. He didn't think that it was possible.
Oh, boy, 1-6 from the bar.
What a joker. Super joker. His best number. His best number.
That's also not too bad.
Yeah, yeah. And let's see what he's going to get here. And looks like he's running away.
It looks like the gammon is saved.
Yes, I think it would have been a bit harsh on Alain to be gammon there with the illegal move. I think this is a little bit fairer.
Yes, but are you sure that it was better than the normal move? I am not so sure.
Yes, yes, it was.
No, it was because it had been forced.
It was very, very, very good.
Yeah, it was better
but
for
I'm
him.
I'm sure that it was not made by purpose. I cannot
No. I think like it was accidental.
So definitely, it was an accidental play, and both of them missed it, which is so incredible.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, it's looking like this is going to be 2 points for Torsten here.
Welcome back to the live backgammon, where things like that happen. The pips are not available, and there are from time to time illegal plays, which makes live backgammon so exciting, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, no doubt about that, Bojo. Well said. Okay, yeah, just going through emotions here before Torsten wins his 2 points.
It looks like it will be 5 away in Alain's favor.
I think so as well. I'll be shocked if he manages to win this pair off here. With so many
too many games. Shocking sequences at this game.
Yeah, it's got to be like 6, 5, 4 versus 2-1, 3-1, 2-1, 2-4. Yeah, okay, there's the resign. There's the resign. Yeah. Okay. 2 points. Torsten.
I would like to share with the viewers my experience with Torsten. I played against him something like 4 or 5 times online. And he's my preferred opponent because we played all times between 3 and 4 PRs, which for him it's quite normal. For me, not, really not. And so it's, I would like to play every time against him.
Ah, he brings the best out of our Gianlazzaro son. Of course, we understand Gianlazzaro. Yes, of course, he's brings you into your best game. Very, very nice. Thank you for sharing. Okay, and
it's okay. Getting cold again.
And I am afraid I have to go there to do something.
Okay,
Gianlazzaro.
Yes.
We would be very appreciative. Thank you, Gianlazzaro. A little gremlin in the works. We've got a little freeze situation here.
It's very cold today.
Yes. Hopefully we can start to warm things up a little bit here and have a few more things ready for this streaming. I'm sure we'll be there soon.
Apologize to the audience.
We do. Oh, okay, we're back. Okay, and I wonder if he has a three. Oh no, it's the ace.
Just one to play, yeah.
Yeah. And looks like it's a 2-5. Yeah.
Torsten has a slightly better front position while he has one checker back extra, so more or less equal game.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about hitting here. I've had to have a look with not much around to cover.
Okay.
Not quite enough checkers in the area. Okay. Yeah.
62.
Very nice. Tidies up. 61.
Maybe time to split the back checkers.
I think so. My preferred play is split with the one and come into the 5 point from the 11 point.
Split with the six also looks reasonable because of the stripped points for Alain on 11 and 13.
I like your idea, actually, Bojo. Well spotted.
But the question is, where is the ace? Because if he moves from 11 to 10, this is not going to duplicate anything.
Yes. Yeah, I wonder what he'll go for here. Sure, we'll find out.
I'm afraid he's getting caught again.
Yeah. Oh, okay. He played
so it. He went for the coming in with 07.
Yeah.
Double force.
Yes, he gave him nothing.
No, those guys should move from the 18 point. Otherwise, he has no timing.
I agree with you. He becomes too kind of front loaded, where something has to give after the double force. I like Bojo's idea. Keeping connectivity, swinging round, and giving yourself much more chance to improve naturally. I think this way.
I would move to the 10 point.
I would as well. I think this way he's creating big problems and he's not improved his position. I think it was better to come all the way round. He's going to need some additional help here. Doesn't have it. So 1 and 3.
3-1, not too bad.
I think he has to unstack with the 3 and then think about ace. Okay, minimum shots. Double sixes. I think it's got to be. Yeah.
Yeah, he would like to keep the two anchors for sure at this moment, but.
Oh,
is that timing good enough?
Is that quads?
Double force?
Yeah, quads. Okay, so yeah, now it's a benefit having the 14 point if he stays there.
I think just all four down is good enough, making the 5 prime. No need to bury a checker.
I agree.
10 point.
Yeah, I think so. The power and the force of that lovely solid 5 prime would make it very difficult for Torsten to get back into this game, but now he has a glimmer.
He has to break the 24 because next time he might be forced to break 20 with 24 still being there. So I'm kind of surprised he played the 2 in.
I agree. Puts his back position under more pressure. Oh!
There is the cube.
Yeah, there is the cube. And I will be shocked if he passes this. Yes, Alain has a
seven away.
Yeah, has a good racing position, but got a huge gap in between his small pillars on the six and deuce point.
And Torsten still has a stronger board.
He does indeed.
And yeah, now he breaks the 24. Why not the previous time?
Yeah, I agree with you. But at least...
if he got 6-1 or 6-3?
Yeah, I agree. What do you think, Gianlazzaro? Would you have split the role before yourself?
Yes, before. I think it was too dangerous to remain on the ace point.
I agree. I like this plan as well. I think that's the stronger move.
This would be my play, I think.
You think this is more favorable than making the three?
Yeah, he has a five-point board, and now he's going to play with one checker out. So this... okay, if it's there, no problem. But if it was closer with four or five, this might have cost. Okay, 3-4. Yeah,
yep.
Look at this. Even now.
Yeah, I can run into now. A few more problems this way.
Bring down the two checkers, the rope before.
Yeah, okay, a bit of daylight there. Okay, still more work to do.
Board strength is equal.
It is indeed. Now he's hoping to roll a 6x and give up the 14.
Six eggs.
Yeah. It's sunny side up or boiled.
Oh, 4-1. The 4-1 is the only roll that is leaving a shot anyway.
Yeah, I think bye-bye 8 point. Yeah.
That's what a bad draw for Alain that was.
It was indeed.
Oops. And there is the hit.
Yeah, 2-3.
Okay. And can he come in?
Fine.
No. So this looks like the end of the game.
Should be, I think. Threatening to close.
Yes, I don't think it is too good.
No. Because you don't always cover immediately, and you may give opponent too many chances to hit you back. So.
Yeah, look at this, guys. Because of the double threes, making the 3 point, this lost him the game.
You're right, Bojo, yes. You had better vision in that position.
Yeah, against three checkers on the golden point, we should not open such wide spaces.
I agree with you.
Against 5 point board, of course. If the board was 3 point board, no problem. But against the 5 point board, this was too risky.
Yes, I was definitely seduced by the purity rather than the most effective way to win the game. Okay, looks like a 5-3. Also known as a 5-3.
So... 0-0 in a 5 point match.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Who's going to do the better here? Let's wait and see. Round three. Lux versus Babillon. Okay, that's the 4 point. You can tell by the fluency of the movement. He enjoyed that roll. He enjoyed that too. Makes the 5.
21. Oh, wow.
Ooh. I would make the 5.
I make the 5 as well, but I'm not so sure in this position.
Wow, both of you with power plays. Probably could be right, but...
Usually it's right making the 5 here, but against the 4 prime could be good to splitting, so yeah.
I slightly prefer this just because... The 6s are very, very big if he rolls it, and you're still stuck on 24 with two checkers. I'm slightly more in favour of Alain's play.
Could be.
Yeah, I think the priming value against the 2 on the 24, here you're trying to either roll an ace or peering out with a six, I think a bit more advantageous.
Okay. Oh, no.
Okay, let's see.
Let's go.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, the risks of the life coverage. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, obviously, we are not very lucky yesterday and today with connection and everything. So please be patient and have mercy. We are trying to take the best of the situation.
We are, and it's out of our hands, of course. We're working the best we can with what we have. We apologize for the inconsistency, but we'll still try to present the best we can, the show, for you to enjoy.
Look at this 31, hitting, sending the checker on the bar and moving to the edge of the prime. I was just about to say that the cube is coming and it might be even a drop, and this 31 absolutely changed the perspective.
By a big margin, all of a sudden, a completely different game. Now, Alain threatening to do better things here. Very, very interesting.
Maybe it is better that I stay there.
Yes, please.
Yeah, we appreciate Gianlazzaro. Thank you. Yeah, trying to maximize the viewing pleasure we have for our viewing audience. Yeah. Yeah, should a little bit of freeze framing here. Okay, there's the reset or the restart. Ah, and there's a cube decision. We don't know who it's for.
Alain has cubed Torsten. I'm pretty sure about that.
Yeah. So there's the drop. Right. Yeah. Yes. Okay. 7-6. 4 away, 5 away.
Okay, we're getting already into the 4 away territory.
We are, and tit for tat now with the score. Very close together.
This score is typical that actually the leader in the match, in this case, Alain, can take deeper and can double earlier than his opponent because of the score, because of the 4-way. While usually the trailer is the bold one and the leader is the more conservative, but not at 5-away, 4-away.
Yes. And it's building up nicely. Alain's got his 18 and a 5-point. Torsten has the advanced anchor and his own 5-point. So, yeah, a kind of offset type of mutual holding game here. Okay, he's having a think about this. Trying to see where he's going to go. Do believe it's double two.
Yes, good play.
Okay. Yeah.
And now the question, do we hit breaking the anchor or not? He's in favor of hitting.
Yeah, gives him a chance to try and get away. Five.
And as so many times today, Torsten is rolling double sixes against one or against 2-point port. He's very unfortunate from the bar.
He is. But Alain starting to pick up some momentum here. Yeah. And 31, very nice.
Very good roll, very good roll. Placing spare checker on each point.
Yeah, so very flexible, hoping for something good to happen next.
Yeah, he might consider doubling here because his formation is very strong.
It is. And
he should go through the low numbers and see if there are bad numbers.
Yeah. I think they're all okay. 2-1, 3-1.
Yeah, 5-1, not the best.
Yeah.
6-1 was definitely much better.
It was. And is now it getting close? Hesitation. Straight there. Oh, look at this. The flowing French flair insta-cube. We like it. Whoop! There you go. Take that 2-cube.
I think that was an easy take.
I concur.
It's not very gammonish because of the anchor, so
yeah,
he can take deeper.
This is the time to clear the 5-2. 21.
Down.
Yeah.
Ah, okay, that's also fine. Slotting the bar.
Yeah, I think he's giving himself a good 4.
How about now?
Yes. Either you point or he has to stacky wacky, doesn't he, the other way?
This looks very ugly, but against the 4-point board, he should be careful.
I agree.
Especially since the cube is already at the other side.
Definitely. Oh.
Okay, this is 6-1 and 8-7.
Ah, okay, yeah. My apologies. For some reason, I thought that Torsten was on the 24, but he's on the 23, so he's absolutely fine. I thought it was a shot-leaving number.
And this is probably going to seal the deal, making the 3-point and stacking the 8.
Yeah, I like your vision here.
Or maybe even making both. No, this I don't think. Maybe he can make 3 and ace as well, being ready for the blitz. I would still go to the 8-point. It's more flexible.
I think so. I think if you get a bit of a pick and pass or get a bit fortunate, so be it. I think.
But this looks good as well.
It does, but you may get into problems with the point that's 6 away. That may give Torsten a few more winning chances. So I think I like your original idea.
This is good because he can play every 6 safe the next roll.
Yes. Yeah.
Also 5-4 and double 5s. Everything is.
Yeah.
Fine.
Okay.
4-1.
I think I just stick it on the 3.
Yes, absolutely.
Keep your versatility here. No, I think this could...
I don't think so.
I think this could get a little awkward.
6-3 is already a nightmare.
Yeah.
But okay, we have double 3s on the other side, which means he has to make some bad thing. So... switching from 4-1 is already giving Len more safety.
Yes. Okay.
Okay, and now he needs a deuce because otherwise it's very gammonish now.
Oh, but look at this now. He's had to open up. And what's he going to roll? Looks like he's pointing.
He's big pointing roll coming up. Deuce.
Big roll coming up. And...
can fine. He get... no.
Uh-oh, close out. Okay.
Yes.
He's on the bike. He's on the road. Here we go. Yeah.
Can Alain win the match here?
Let's wait and see. He's starting to flow.
He has approximately 65, maybe even a bit over 65% chance to win a gammon.
Yes, absolutely. Let's see.
Okay, maybe the checker on the deuce is reducing a little bit his gammon chances.
And so is this roll as well, as he's a bit front-loaded here. Okay, he's cleared.
Okay, now there is good chance for Torsten if he can get the 6. Well done.
Very well done. Fast six at the moment. Double
fours. This is double fours.
Yeah, quads.
Two off, but 2 points open. So, a good news for Torsten.
Yeah. And he's definitely in, I think, he may be giving Forrest Gump a call.
He has five rows now. Four more left, if no doubles.
Yeah, let's see. It's
probably just about to be enough. Alain with another double that is not efficient.
That's right, a double ducks there, but I'm sure Torsten will be delighted with that.
Okay, this one is efficient.
Okay, that's very efficient. Is that the Junisa Flair? Let's see. He's
okay,
on there.
Double fives and double
and,
sixes.
Okay, monster favorite. And
congratulations, Monsieur Babillon.
Yes, congratulations. Yes, great stuff there.
Okay.
Yeah. Victorious through to round four. Congratulations, Monsieur Babillon. Commiserations. Torsten looks. What did you think overall about the match there, Boja? What did you feel? What did you think?
The match was interesting with a couple of very exciting games. Alain got the early lead, then the Torsten managed to come back, but this was not enough since Alain striked exactly when he needed with this last game, Gammon. So, yeah, good luck to Alain in the next rounds, and also good luck to Torsten in the... what is it? It's not second chance, but it's the lower part of the draw in the defeated. So yeah, they are both still in the tournament, and we may stream them again in the later rounds.
Yes, who knows how all these things are going to pan out? Yes, and yes, do come and join us a bit later. We're going to try our best. Bring you the best viewing experience we can. We'll try and iron out and see if we can get rid of a few of these gremlins that are coming in now and again. But one thing for sure, we'll try our best to give you the best presentation and broadcast we can under the circumstances. Do keep an eye on YouTube and the WBGF website for results and other actions. And we look forward to seeing you on the stream sometime very soon. Enjoy, have a good afternoon, and ciao, Bella.